Okay, so we're highlighting, profiling Noah Igbinoghene, the former cornerback at Auburn, hanging out with my man, former linebacker at Auburn, Deshaun Davis. All right, so Noah, that's who you, I asked you what his nickname is, and you said Noah.
Noah's just Noah, man.
Noah's just Noah.
Yeah.
So why is Noah just Noah? Tell us a little bit more about the wide receiver turned cornerback.
I think when you talk about Noah, I think that's what excited a lot of scouts, you know, about him. You know, the fact that he did play wide receiver, comes from a track background. You know, mom and dad, he ran track at Auburn, performed pretty well. He only played cornerback for 2 years.
Yeah.
And he moved the corner in the spring and started the first game on a defense who was top 15 against Washington. So that's, I mean, his resume, you know, kind of speaks for itself. he's still kind of raw. You know, he has a really high ceiling, but I mean, I know he's going to test well. He's going to jump high, going to run fast, but he still has a lot of growing to do. And when you're talking about a prospect, an NFL prospect, that's what a lot of scouts want to see. You know, how can we develop this guy? Mm-hmm. You know, how much room does he have to grow? You know, he's going to peak in 2 years, or can he peak in 5 years and sustain for another 4 years before we can get another corner? So if a lot of teams are looking for something like that, you know, high character guy, someone who's, you know, kind of quiet, doesn't really make a lot of noise, but he just comes in and works all the time. You know, real strong corner, physical corner, likes to put his hands on receivers. You know, I feel like a good team is going to really grab him and he's going to have success.
Here, as we get closer to the NFL draft, we've seen his draft stock begin to rise.
Yeah.
Some mock drafts are saying potential late first round draft pick. Mm-hmm. What do you think that attributes to?
Basically what I was just saying, you know, by him being so raw, you know, them seeing his athletic ability, and when he does some really good things on tape, it's just like, wow, that's not normal. Mm-hmm. I think that's what a lot of people see, that he makes some mistakes, you know, he gets some pass interference and stuff. You can credit that to him not being at the position very long and not having a lot of experience, but when he makes those wild plays, there's some guys who's been playing corner all their life that can't do what he's doing in 2 years. So when they see that and they see them, like, they know he has the track background, looking for speed at the corner position, know he's going to be a guy who can run, very explosive, can jump, know he's going to be a high competitor. I mean, it all speaks for itself. You know, he's checking every box, you know, when it comes to that. So, you know, hopefully he can slip in that first round and from the way he tests. But if he's going to be a second round pick, you know, I know he's not going to complain about that either. But I'm really excited to see where he ends, you know, towards the end of his career. So, I mean, I guess the sky's the limit for him.